you're talking about changing attitudes, and we have actually another question on social media, and possibly you could use social media to change these attitudes. This other question that we had came from a Lim Zi Wen, asking if governing has become much harder than before, and whether the pervasiveness of social media has made it difficult to canvass support for your policies.
I think governing has become harder than before. Social media is part of the reason, because people are communicating rapidly. Before, while I'm making a speech, people are tweeting one another and sharing pictures and comments. And that's the way it is. It's not just my speech. A football game is like that. Some entertainment event is like that. It's part of the experience, which makes it a more intense experience, faster moving, more interesting. But at the same time, maybe faster than we're able to cope until you come to a decision before really you've had time to think it over, pause, digest it, and then reach a considered conclusion. So Michael Bloomberg, who is mayor of New York, very successful businessman before that, he was in Singapore a couple of years ago, and he said in Singapore that, you know, with the social media, you're having a 24/7 referendum. Every move you make is judged instantly, pass, fail, up, down, is like the Singapore Idol. The news went back to America. He made this comment at lunchtime. By evening, it had gone viral in America. There was a reaction.
His press secretary had come out.
His press secretary had come out and explain, no, he didn't mean this in a scolding way. But it is a problem. On the other hand, there are good things you can do with the social media. When we had the haze recently, some people put together a website and you could identify where N95 masks were available so people could get the information, share the information, act on it, and get together and work together on it. And that's something you couldn't do without the before the social media. But there are problems. One problem is bullying. You see in cases, in real life, of course, it happens from time to time. So cyberspace, it takes a new form. In America, children get bullied, sometimes commit suicide, happens not so infrequently. In Singapore, too, there have been journalists who have written articles, and they've got flamed. That's one thing. In one case, there was a lady whose telephone number got taken and posted onto a porn site. And she was getting phone calls. So this is a real problem when the law hasn't really caught up with this. Another problem is just facts. When the newspaper gets facts wrong, we write to them, here are the correct facts, you put it right. If a TV station gets facts wrong, tomorrow there's the same TV program, well, you make a clarification or correction, the same eyeballs more or less are there. But on the internet, you put one fact out, or untruth out, or mistake out, which spreads all over the space. How do you send the truth chasing after the untruth all over the place and catch up with it? It's quite a problem. Not just Singapore, but really all over the world. And we have to think how we're going to deal with these things.